this could be us. So back to what I was saying. Could be us.
Good day, guys. Today we're gonna compare my favorite builds on the Sandivistan. Since we already acquired the 3 seconds cooldown Sandy on my cyberware. As you can see, I only have 3 seconds cooldown and will be using with the 3 legendary heatsink you can acquire with the max crafting. We also need the nano relay, the currency cob, the heal on kill. We will be using the same cyberware for every try so we can know the best output. So our best test, we're gonna use this L69 Suwon, the smart shotgun, so we don't miss even we move fast on our target. I'm using a controller, so I'm not good at precision sniping. That's why I love to use smart gun. So bear with me, guys. So this is my skill. I really saved the attribute points for this, so I can test it out. We're gonna max the body until 18. We're gonna reset the perks point and put it on all to shotgun. Just read the description, guys. It's easy to understand. We take all the offensive because I like being Rambo. Like in your face, running gun, perfect for our Sandy. There's no sneaking, we just run and kill all the dudes. I see also a disadvantage here because in our reflex we don't need any perks, so we just wasted our 18 points. Maybe we use that just to wear the Sandivistan. Maybe 16 points will be enough for this. Blood pumping right on the face of the enemy. I take 3 shot on average to put down the enemy. By the way guys, it's on all very hard difficulty. Now we will use the melee build using the Satori katana. As in the same, I put all in the cool and put whatever perks that will add our bonus damage. Just read the perks guides. Badass. Actually, it's good because the your speed is matched by your melee weapon, unlike bullets. Now we will try my favorite build, the SMG smart weapon using the Linglong. Same as before, we will reset our skill and put on damage on reflex and cold blood.
Thank you.
Just takes too many bullets to take down the enemy. So this, so far this is the weakest build, but this is the build that why it's my favorite, because in the first, when you're low level, you don't have Sandy, so this is the perfect build. Now we will try the handgun build, the Comrad hammer using Sandivistan. As always, we will take the perks with damage. We don't need defense. The 3 seconds is our defense. That's our only defense period. So we take all damage all the way. This gun hit like a truck. I think anyone you can watch with this gun, and also it can pass through wall. So if we summarize all our tryouts. So in my hierarchy, the first one will be the katana build, then this comrade hammer, then the shotgun build, and the SMG build for the last. Head down. Pros and cons in katana build. Melee is the best because when you use the sandy, the melee will also increase speed unlike bullets. The cons only, it can be boring sometimes when you use always a katana. Pros and cons in comrade hammer, it can press the wall, you can one shot everything. The cons is you have to scope when you're using a controller. Sometimes, like me, I'm not good on scoping, and also it becomes boring when you one shot everything, so the difficulty must be very hard. For the shotgun build, I think it's decent. You can 3-shot enemy, but the cons there, the reflex that you put is wasted, so I think you just need a it must be more applicable on berserk. On SMG build, as much as I want it to be working, but on comparison, it's the weakest build for the Sandivistan. That's it guys, thank you for watching. Like and subscribe for more. So back to what I was saying. Could be honest.